go get your Bibles and turn to the book of Hebrews.
Amen.
Chapter 12. Hebrews chapter 12, beginning in verse
1. Amen.
Get there, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the word of God reads, wherefore singing, we also are compassed about what so great a cloud of witness. Let us lay aside every weight and the sins which do it so easily beset us. And let us run with patience the race that is set before us. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him that endures such contradictions of sinners against himself, lest ye be weary and faint in your mind. The grass withered, the flowers faded, but the word of God stands forever. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Just want to talk to you a little bit about having the right perspective. We're living in a time now that we don't know what's right and we don't know what's wrong. We see so much communication that's being filtered out in the air, whether it's on television, whether it's the radio, whether it's the internet, whether it's the bloggers, whether you're tweeting it out. It is so much information out there now that can cloud our mind.
Amen.
But God always have a remedy.
Oh yeah.
We already know that this world is not our home.
Amen.
You've heard that. For some time on this journey, we just need to be reminded.
Amen.
We are only just pilgrims passing through. But each day, we are striving every day to cross the finishing line. To see Jesus. Anybody just want to see Jesus' face?
Yes.
I don't know about you, but one thing I'm glad about, though, that on this journey, I'm glad that I don't have to journey alone.
Amen.
Because I'm glad I got a father that says hi. And he looks low. And he journeyed every step of the way.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he promised me and you that he would never leave you alone. That he would be with you until the end of time. And so here, even today, and all the trouble that surrounds us and everything that's going on in the world, trouble and difficulty are part of life journey. And if we expect any otherwise, we're going to constantly be disappointed, discouraged, depressed. Even to the way that we have become despair about so much that goes goes on around us, in our lives, and through our lives.
Yes.
But then when I look at the book of Ecclesiastes.
Yeah.
It tells us and make it clear and plain to us. To everything.
Yes, it is.
Didn't say some things. It says to everything.
Yes.
There is a season.
Yes.
Yes, it is.
We're in a season right now that we're going into winter.
Amen.
We got spring, we got summer, we got fall, and we got winter.
Amen.
And those are all the seasons of the year.
Yes.
But then what we forget about is that life has season two.
Amen.
Yeah.
Even in this life, sometimes our season is filled with joy.
Yes.
Sometimes our season is filled with sorrow.
Yes.
And yet it still, sometimes we say, I don't understand. I go to church. I pray.
Yes.
I pay my tithes. I try to be as humble as I know how to be.
Yes.
Amen.
In this life,
yes,
we will face trouble.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
But the one thing about it, you may not understand. But the one thing that I do know, God does understand.
Amen.
Because the word says, whatever we may be going through,
amen,
He's not going to put no more on us.
Amen.
Then we can bear.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, the fact is, seasons going to change. And so that means in your life there's going to be change.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
But then we serve a God that is always the same.
Amen.
And so when you bring the right perspective to it, and we serve a God that says that He never changes, He's the same yesterday and today and forevermore, then that means that whatever we do yesterday, and if He brought us out, He is the same God that can bring us out today.
Amen.
Oh, if we look back then in the Old Testament time, and if we say He did it for Abraham, then He can do it today. If He did it for David, He can do it today. If He did it for the Hebrew boys, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, He can still do it today. If He did it for Daniel,
yes.
He can still do it today. Bring on the right perspective.
Yes.
He said, I don't change. See, people change.
Yes.
But I don't change.
Amen.
I stay the same.
Amen.
And you know what? Because Paul makes it very clear that he doesn't change, because he says that, you know what? Because our God is faithful.
Yes. Yes.
Now we look at it and say, we know God is faithful.
Amen.
Oh, He's going to be faithful to you in good times and in bad times.
Yeah.
But the question is, it's not about how faithful God is to us. The question is how faithful we are to God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want God to do this and do that. And so when trouble comes, you know what? The first thing then we do cry out to Him. Uh-huh. And that's who you should cry out, that we know that we need God.
Yeah.
But why don't you cry out to Him when you don't need Him?
Amen.
Yeah.
Why don't you seek Him when you don't need Him?
Amen.
Why you wait to just seek Him in the bad times?
Yeah.
Why don't you just serve Him in the good times?
Yeah.
Because He's faithful to you, and He'll still pick you up out of your bad times.
Yeah.
Because grace is His faithfulness.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Then when you look at it, none of us who enjoys trouble. Wouldn't it be nice if this could all just be a bed of roses? That's where the saying comes from.
Yeah.
Life is not all a bed of roses.
Yeah.
You know what? He never promised, and He never told us that we were not going to go through anything.
Yeah.
He never promised that we were not going to suffer. too.
Yeah.
So what about us?
Yeah.
No.
So none of us enjoy trouble. But trouble comes.
Amen.
And even when it comes, and we face the hardship of it, we face the discouragement of it, somebody that disappointed, somebody right now, thank you, Holy Spirit, somebody right now is disappointed. Because, you know, we can plan our lives.
Yeah.
And then sometimes God comes in and says, no, that's not the way I want to send you.
Yeah.
Because I don't think that's the best way that you should travel.
Uh-huh.
I don't think that's the best way that you should go.
Uh-huh.
And sometimes he takes it and messes up our plan, and you know what? We get all discouraged.
Uh-huh.
And mercy.
And it is easy to lose the big picture.
Yeah.
But here, when we look back, didn't start in chapter 12 of Hebrews.
Mm-hmm.
But when we look back in chapter 11,
yes,
it talks about that great cloud of witness.
Uh-huh.
How they all live by faith.
Yes.
Yeah.
I like it when it starts off because it says the first one, what? Abraham lived by faith.
Yeah.
In other words, you know what Abraham did? Abraham took his son Isaac, whom he loved, but he offered him up for a sacrifice, put him on that altar.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, look what his son says to him.
Uh-huh.
As they journeyed along.
Yeah.
When Daddy, we done made the altar, I see the fire. But where is the lamb?
Uh-huh. I know.
Uh-huh.
And Abraham says, you know what? God will provide. Anybody know that God will provide?
Yes, he will.
He will provide.
Yeah.
But Abraham was by his faith that he laid his son on that altar.
Yeah.
And just about to take his own son's life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Not because he wanted to. But do you realize he was being obedient to God?
Yes.
Amen.
And so when he picked it up to take it, then there was the voice that says, Abraham, stay your hand.
Yeah.
Don't you touch him.
Yeah.
I'm with
you. Look over there.
Uh-huh.
You see, that's where it says, a ram in the bush. Look at that ram in that thing.
Uh-huh.
He knows how to make a way for you.
Yeah.
He may not come when you want him to, but if you just hold on and be obedient to him, he will come right on time. He made a way for Abraham and Isaac.
Yes.
And just like he made a way for Abraham and Isaac, he can make a way for you.
Yeah.
Because I just believe that if he did it yesterday, then I know that he's still able to do it today, because he tells me, I don't change, sister. I stay the same.
Yeah.
Amen.
But you got to align your perspective right with God.
Yeah.
Amen.
You got to be in his will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so it talks about this great cloud of witness.
Mm-hmm.
And even today, they will live by faith.
Yeah.
And do you know, in all their obedience? And sometimes we get discouraged because, you know what? Well, I wanted my life to go this way and it didn't happen.
Uh-huh.
I thought I'd be married and have a husband now. It didn't happen.
Uh-huh.
I thought I'd be driving this kind of car, and I don't have it.
Uh-huh.
I thought I'd be living in this kind of home, but I don't have it.
Uh-huh.
And instead of complaining about what you don't have, you ought to be thanking God for what you do have, because this great cloud of witnesses, they live by faith.
Yeah.
And yet and still, they live and they die and did not receive all the promises that was before them. But the one thing that they did not lose out on. They did not lose their vision.
Yeah.
They did not lose their perspective, that their vision of heaven.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
And on this journey that matters, in the text.
Yes.
When you look at it, it tells us, first of all, we got to lay aside the weights.
Yes, yes.
That's right.
I don't know what may be holding you down today. I don't know what may be having you shackled down. But whatever it is, the Bible says that you got to lay it aside.
Yes.
Amen.
Whatever may entangle or endanger your relationship with God.
Yes.
Amen.
It's all about what we think.
I know.
You got to lay the weight aside. Whatever it is that you're thinking and you, because God says, I don't think like y'all think.
Amen.
My ways and my thoughts are different.
Yeah.
And so he said, well, you got to lay it aside. I don't care what you're going through. It makes it clear in 1 Peter, and it tells us that we ought to cast all our cares.
Amen.
Upon who? Upon Jesus, because he cares.
Yeah.
He already knows what you're going through.
Amen.
But whatever it is and how we think, because it's like, whatso does a man think it, so is he. If you know what, if you already think I ain't gonna be nothing, well then guess what? You won't be nothing.
Yeah.
If you don't think that you can climb the ladder, then you'll never climb.
Amen.
If you don't ever think that, you know what, I can be the best and I will be whatever man, then you'll never be the best.
Yeah.
If you're always just thinking negative, then guess what? You're gonna walk around all the time just being a negative thinking person. Where you think you're going, only what you do for your joy.
Amen.
Because if the Lord gave it to you, can't nobody steal it.
Amen.
Because the joy that you have today, if God give it to you, then can't the world sure can't take it away from you.
Amen.
Because the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
Cast your cares upon him, because whatever you and you gotta run it with patience. And the object of any race is to win it. We all can't run a race if we don't go to training. And look at Paul. Paul used it as an analogy of an athlete. If anybody know anything about an athlete, you gotta practice. You gotta work out. You gotta exercise. You gotta watch your diet. And you gotta train. And so now we gotta train. You got to run out to ensure
Yes.
It's clear that there's a cloud. That's made up. For each and every one.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
But no cross.
Yes. No crown.
No crown.
Yes.